Welcome. Good evening and welcome to our graduation mass. We come together to give thanks to God for the many blessings and opportunities we have experienced during our time at De La Salle Catholic College Cronulla. We have been enriched by the presence and contribution of all the staff at the college and the LaSallian brothers.
As a result of our time at the college, we hope to continue to be agents of change in our world, striving to emulate the gospel values and the virtues of St. John Baptist de La Salle. In the words of St. John Baptist de La Salle, may God continue what he has begun in you. As always, when we gather as a college, we say, Deo Duce. Our Year 12 students will now process in. Please stand for our entrance hymn.
Lord, we bring our thanks. and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome to St. Aloysius Church this evening for this graduation mass. Welcome to our Year 12 graduates. Welcome to their families, their parents, siblings, grandparents, and others who've joined us this evening. Welcome to our staff and to our extended community. Tonight is a great night of joy. Joy, not that school has ended, not that you don't have to wear your uniform anymore, but it's a joy that you've come to a completion of your schooling. You've still got a little bit of studies to come, but it's a joy for the support of all of us to be able to gather together. Over the last few years, we haven't been able to gather quite like this, and it's a joy for me as the parish priest here to see a church that's overflowing this evening. So welcome to you all. I welcome my assistant priest, Father Frank Regala, and we also welcome Father Michael Casita, who just returned from Uganda just a couple of days ago, returned to the parish just yesterday afternoon. So we welcome him back to Cronulla after his ordination in Uganda a few weeks back. So welcome to Father Michael. I invite you now to please be seated for our candle ceremony.
This evening marks a special time for us. Year 12 graduating students of 2022. It is an ending, but it is also a beginning. We tell the story of ending and beginning. The Easter light, the symbol of Christ, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
Of the college, I offer you the light of wisdom. Carry this light from this place to a world that stands in need of wisdom. A world that faces decisions and choices never dreamed of in the past. Remember that everything you learned in school was learnt in the company of others. Be open to learning ahead of you. May you be a light of wisdom for others. May you grow in wisdom that will inspire you to find the good and true.
On behalf of all parents gathered here this evening, I offer you the light of love. This is a light we lit for you a long time ago. It is the light you depended on in those early days, the light you ran to when things went wrong, the light that was left on for you because you were afraid of the dark. This is the light that waited up for you if you were late home, and the light that was always there, even though sometimes, just sometimes, you wish it wasn't. Carry this light of love into a world where real love is rare and precious. Use it to light the path of your own search to love and be loved. And when you find that the light is flickering, blown about by the troubles of life, remember that there will always be a light burning for you in that place called home.
I offer you the light of faith. The most important thing about the light of faith is that it is not yours alone. A lone flame cannot pierce the darkness, but many flames together can cast a great light. Be part of the Christian community wherever you can find it. Be as God has called you to be. As the stars in the night, as the sun in the sky. A source of light for all you will meet on the way. While the candles of our graduates tonight remain unlit, look for opportunities in the future to be a light for the world. Now to please stand. Let us now acknowledge the times we have failed to be that light of Christ in the world. Let us repent of our sins and ask the Lord now for mercy. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you have poured out upon your people the Spirit of truth. Christ of mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us now say together the praise of God as we say, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who with untold mercy we're pleased to choose as an apostle St. Matthew, the tax collector. Grant that sustained by his example and intercession, we may merit to hold firm in following you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. I, the prisoner in the Lord, implore you to lead a life worthy of your vocation. Bear with one another charitably, in complete selflessness, gentleness, and patience. Do all you can to preserve the unity of the Spirit by the peace that binds you together. There is one body, one spirit, just as you were all called into one and the same hope when you were called. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God, who is the Father of all, over all, through all, and within all. Each one of us, however, has been given his own share of grace, given as Christ allotted it. To some, his gift was that they should be apostles, to some, prophets, to some, evangelists, to some, pastors and teachers, so that the saints together make a unity in the work of service, building up the body of Christ. In this way, we are all to come to unity in our faith and in our knowledge of the Son of God, until we become the perfect man, fully mature with the fullness of Christ himself. The word of the Lord.
And I want to follow wherever he leads me, wherever he goes. Over the mountains, the waters and byways, valleys and highways, he's waiting for me. And I want to follow wherever he leads me, wherever he goes. While on the journey to where we are going, he promised to be there to help us along. And over the mountains we'll walk on together to know all the wonders he's given to me. I want to go to meet him there, to lay myself down in his love. The Lord is my shepherd, and I want to follow wherever he leads me, wherever he goes.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. As Jesus was walking on, he saw a man named Matthew sitting by the customs house, and he said to him, "Follow me." and he got up and followed him. While he was at dinner in the house, it happened that a number of tax collectors and sinners came to sit at the table with Jesus and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your master eat with tax collectors and sinners?" When he heard this, he replied, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. Go and learn the meaning of the words, 'What I want is mercy, not sacrifice.' And indeed, I did not come to call the virtuous, but sinners." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today in the life of the church, we celebrate the feast day of St. Matthew the Apostle and the gospel writer of the Gospel of Matthew. Matthew is known as the Apostle of Mercy. His gospel, from the very beginning to the very end, introduces and strengthens us in the idea of mercy. And many of the students here who are graduating tonight, before you came to De La Salle at Cronulla, you went to Our Lady of Mercy College at Barronier Bay. A school focuses on mercy. Matthew's gospel has the beautiful beatitudes, the teachings of Jesus on the way of happiness. And within that, a blessed are the merciful. The life and the story of St. Matthew is one of experiencing mercy. And I hope for those who are here tonight, our graduates, but also parents and others who are gathered tonight, we can reflect a little on the life of St. Matthew. Matthew gives us perhaps an encouragement for ourselves. He was a guy who was initially hated by his community. He was isolated. He had no friends. He was perhaps the loner in society. He was very good, though, at what he did. He was very good at maths. He was very good at business and became the lead tax collector in his town. He worked not for his own people, the Jewish people, but he worked for the Roman Empire. So he was good at maths. He was probably very good intellectually. But this created some disunity and disharmony with his own community. And that's not the way learning and knowledge are meant to bring about our life, in our lives. We are called to use our knowledge, our gifts, to bring about unity, to bring about relationships and not disharmony. Sometimes in school, and I remember what it was like in school, I also remember it at university and even in seminary, studying to be a priest, sometimes people can become a little competitive. And this can happen in our own lives, it can happen in business, it can happen in all sorts of contexts where you sort of think, oh, that person over there, they're in my way. And we try to almost bring them down. We seem to have this mentality sometimes in Australia. We sometimes refer to it as tall poppy syndrome. We drag someone down who's doing well, almost creating disunity and disharmony. Our readings today are the readings for this feast day of St. Matthew, but they're perfect for a graduation. I'm going to read a few little passages from our first reading, St. Paul writing to the Ephesians. "Bear with one another charitably." If you haven't got something out of your time here at De La Salle, is that we're all called to be people of charity. And even when somebody else makes a mistake, we're called to be people of charity. "I implore you to lead a life worthy of your vocation, your calling. Each and every one of you have a vocation, a calling. You're called to this moment, but you're called to be great in the world." There was a great president who said these words: "We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, or fabulous. Actually, who am I not to be? These words, a great president in South Africa, a guy called Nelson Mandela, you might have heard of him. He went on to say that you are a child of God. We were born to make manifest the glory of God within us. It is not just in some of us, it is in every one of us. This is a modern take, perhaps, of what St. Paul wrote to the Ephesians. St. Paul said that we are one body, one spirit, but we are all gifted uniquely. Some are gifted to be great apostles or preachers. Some are gifted to be great academics. Some are gifted through their works of service. But we all have a part to play. And hopefully your experiences at De La Salle over the last 2 years, even in the midst of COVID, has inspired you to realize that we can all work together and that we are strongest when we are united. And tonight is a sign of great unity. Unity for our community, unity for our world, unity for our families. And we should smile to say, yes, isn't it great that we are gathering tonight? Not just that it's great that school's coming to an end, but it's great that we have this ability to be united. And the heart of what it means to be Christians is to be willing to listen to God's call in our life and to do what we can to live it out in excellence in our world and help others to live it out in excellence as well. Each and every one of us are called to perfection. But the story of our lives is that we don't always get 100%. Most people get 100% maybe once or twice in their life. We'll have a few people this evening who will get a few awards for their perhaps a few attempts or many attempts at 100%. But the story of Jesus is one of mercy. And that's where I started our reflection this evening. Mercy is a recognition that we aren't perfect. And we don't just leave people in imperfection. The story of Jesus is saying, yes, I want you to be perfect. I want you to be the best you can be. And so Jesus creates a community, and then he gives him his life to help us to be the best we can be. And hopefully you've got through your experience of education, you're realizing, yes, you want to be the best. But you'll also probably realize that as you're graduating tonight, you aren't perfect. None of us in this church are perfect. And so we need the mercy of God and the mercy of each other to help each other every day to bring out the best in us. And tonight we have a lot of people to thank for getting us to this point. Look around, graduates of the church right now. You might be able to see your parents, your grandparents. You might see some of your siblings. You might see your teachers, your principal. You might see your priests, and you might even see each other. The path of perfection doesn't come to an end simply because you graduate from school. The path of perfection goes through us for the entire life. And as Christians, we desire and we want the very best for you. And so it doesn't come to an end tonight. When you're feeling like you're not your best in life, come into this church. Seek the assistance of God. Seek the assistance of others. When you're feeling like you are at perfection and you are doing your best, come into this church and help others. Because the life of charity isn't just something that we bottle up to just hand out every now and then. When we're doing well, we help others. And you've learnt that story, you've learnt that way over many, many years from your family, from your teachers, from your school, from your faith. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous? Actually, who am I not to be? Nelson Mandela wanted the best in every person. and he did what he could to lift others up. Jesus does the same for us. Earlier this week on Monday, Queen Elizabeth was buried. You may have watched some of the funeral. During the pandemic, she said just a few little words. She said, "We will meet again." These were used as the focus for the homily that was given on Monday evening by the Archbishop of Canterbury at her funeral. We will meet again. Tonight is not the end of our relationship together. For those who are graduating, tonight is not the opportunity to say, "Goodbye, I'll never see you again." You mightn't see each other for another 5 years. You mightn't see each other for 20 years. But remember who you graduated with. Remember your friends, and perhaps remember the other people who are around you. You'd say, "Well, if I don't see you for 5 years, it's not that big a deal." However, as Christians, we know we will meet again. Pray for each other and pray tonight that each of us will choose to be the best version of what God is calling us to be. This is what our readings are encouraging us to think about tonight. The story of St. Matthew, he was a great intellectual, a great mathematician, a great businessman. But Jesus says, "You can do better." And Jesus said, "Come, follow me." Tonight, don't give up on your faith. Don't give up on following in the way of Jesus Christ. Because the way of Jesus Christ helps to bring mercy. It helps to bring love. It helps to bring charity and peace to our world. This is the way that we're called to be on. Let's not give up on this way. And let us be the children of God who are born, as Nelson Mandela said, to manifest the glory of God that is within us. On this most significant graduation celebration, it is with confidence that we now bring our prayers to God, who extends mercy to all people.
We pray for the Church, Francis, our Pope, our bishops, priests and deacons, leaders in the Catholic education, that they may be strengthened by your Spirit to continue to provide inspiration and leadership to your people. May the Pope's message to heed the city, to heed the cry of the earth and the cry of the poor, inspire us to open our hearts and our minds to the injustice in our world and to take responsibility to initiate change. Lord, hear us.
We pray for those who govern us, that the leaders of our country and countries around the world might find ways to bring an end to war, violence, injustice and oppression, and promote real and lasting peace amongst all nations. Lord, hear us.
We pray for the graduates of 2022, that the members of this graduating class continue to be carried steadfastly through the path of life, in faithfulness to the ideals to which they have been called. We pray that they be blessed with loyal friends who will help them on their journey. Lord, hear us.
We pray for the brothers, our teachers, office staff, our parents and our families. We thank them for their commitment to our growth, for challenging us and for caring for us. May we continue to use our knowledge and gifts to be agents in the change of our world. We ask that God's blessing on each of us and each of them, and thank them for their love, support, guidance, and encouragement throughout our years of education. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear us.
We pray for our departed loved ones, those much-loved parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts, siblings, and friends who are here with us in spirit, that they may enjoy the radiant dawn of eternal life. Lord, hear us.
God, our loving Father,
You sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to bring us true freedom. We thank you for the abundant blessings you continue to give to your people. Enlighten us with your word and strengthen us with your Holy Spirit as we make these prayers in Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated. Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we celebrate anew the memory of St. Matthew, we bring you sacrifices and prayers, O Lord, humbly imploring you to look kindly on your church, whose faith you have nourished by the preaching of the apostles through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and to offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim together. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall,
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray the partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Anthony, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
I invite you to please stand, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy
we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. 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 Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The Holy Communion Antiphon. I did not come to call the just, but sinners, says the Lord. Holy Communion will be distributed in a moment. For those upstairs, there'll be someone who at either end of the upstairs who will come to distribute communion. I think the easiest way is some people come across the front to come to receive communion, then you'll find a way to do it in a manageable way upstairs. For those downstairs, you come forward by the centre aisle or the aisles near the windows and spread out across the front to have a moment with Christ in front of the altar, receive communion, consume communion, and then return via the middle aisles. For those who are not of the Catholic tradition, I encourage you to come forward as well, and you can receive a blessing, which you can do so by placing your hands over your shoulders.
Simple cup of wine, the fruit of your bed. Tell me all about the day you had. Lay beside me, it's time to rest. You can close your eyes, you've done your best. Let me be your sanctuary. Let me be your safe place to fall. I can take away your worries, the refuge from it all. All this time we have together is our shelter from the rain. I will share this weight you carry. Let me be your sanctuary. We have weathered through the storms, taking comfort in each other's arms. When the dark clouds come again, I will lift you up and take you in. Let me be your sanctuary. Let me be your safe place to fall. I can take away your worries, the refuge from it all. All this time we have together is our shelter from the rain. I will share weight you carry. Let me be your sanctuary. I will share this weight you carry. Let me be your sanctuary.
Let us pray. Sharing in that saving joy, O Lord, with which St. Matthew welcomed the Saviour as a guest into his home, we pray, grant that we may always be renewed by the food we receive from Christ, who came to call not just the just, but sinners to salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. I invite all of our congregation to please be seated, except our Year 12 graduates, who will now recite together the graduates' prayer.
That your blessing be upon us as we come to the end of our time as students of the college and move forward to a future full of opportunities. Thank you for our parents, staff at the college, and friends, and all those people who have contributed to help us reach this point today. Grateful for all the love and guidance we have received, we ask you to help us move forward and fulfill our potential. Be a light unto our paths always. We ask this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I invite you all now to please stand. In a moment, we're going to have the final blessing, and then we will have our concluding song for the Mass. Myself and the other priests will then process out, and we'll then be seated. There will be a couple of speeches, and then there will be our awards ceremony. On my part, I thank all those who have helped prepare for our Mass tonight, for our celebration, and thank you to all of our graduates for allowing the light of Christ into your heart and allowing that to shine out into the world. The Lord be with you. Let's bow our heads and pray now for God's blessings. May God, the Father of lights, who is pleased to enlighten the disciples' minds by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by his blessings and make you always abound with the gifts of that same Holy Spirit. Amen. May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with its purifying light. Amen. And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of the one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith, and by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision. Amen. And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you all and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Soul, worship his holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning, it's time to sing your song again, whatever may pause and whatever
everyone be seated. Look, that's the conclusion of our graduation mass, but that's just the first part of our celebration this evening. We're going to enjoy a very short musical in just a minute of one of our Year 12 students, Alec Durante, who's going to play for us while we get the second part of our celebration organised and ready. Please enjoy.
Thanks so much, Alec. Well, good evening, Father James, Father Frank, Father Michael, and we congratulate you, Father Michael, on your ordination. Brother John, parents, carers, staff, Year 12 graduating students. I delivered an address at this morning's Year 12 final assembly, which I will publish in this week's college newsletter, if you weren't there. I would just like to briefly mention a few things from tonight's graduation mass. Firstly, to Father James and to the St. Aloysius Parish, thank you for your guidance and the spiritual opportunities that you have provided to our Year 12 students, not just tonight, but over the past 2 years at De La Salle College at Cronulla. Parents, tonight signifies the end of 13 years of a Catholic education for your daughter or son. A type of education that you went out of your way to choose because it models La Sallean values and attempts to teach in the way of Jesus. Thank you for your support particularly during the past 2 years during their HSC journey. Year 12, I hope that you are proud to have been educated in a LaSallean school. A school characterised by its Catholic values and personal relationships. Its emphasis on academic and vocational excellence, faith formation, inclusion, respect for the individual, in service, and social justice. A school where young people coming from different social and family backgrounds educate one another by mutual understanding, respect, openness of each, growth in the spirit of service, and in the practice of justice and charity. Our Mass this evening offered you the light of wisdom, of love, and of faith. Please use the opportunity in life to light up the world before you. We hope that the busyness of life and the new opportunities beginning for you next year and beyond do not stand in the way of spending time and making sacrifices to the LaSallean core principles of faith in the presence of God, concern for the poor and the poor justice, and respect for all persons. Please embrace all of these principles as you go from here this evening. So, to the graduating class of 2022, as staff, parents, family, and friends, we send you forth with our congratulations and blessings into the new chapter of your lives. May God be your leader, and may you be guided by the LaSallean principles. Commit yourselves to the life of faith and excellence, compassion, courage, and loyalty. Have a humble heart, a generous spirit, and a willingness to serve our community. Be inspired by a burning zeal to do what is right and just. And as you go before us, never lose the sense to commit yourselves to the blue and gold. Thank you very much. And I'd now like to invite Charlotte Fullerton and Zach Ponte to be able to give their address.
Good evening, Father James, Father Frank, Father Michael, Mr. Marnie, Mrs. Morrison, Brother John, staff, parents, and the class of 2022. I would like to start with a quote that I believe resonates with our experience at De La Salle Cronulla. Without water drops, there can be no oceans. Without steps, there can be no stairs. Without little things, there can be no big things. So what is it about the little things that we have experienced over the past 2 years that matter so much? Little things such as the strong relationships we have formed with our teachers, the classroom jokes, conversations in between classes, and recess and lunchtime talks with our mates. Over the past few weeks, as I have reflected on my journey at De La Salle Cronulla, I've come to realise the true value of these little moments that have not only brought us happiness and joy, but have helped us shape us into the people we are today. These little experiences are the memories that we will remember forever and are what will help us to accomplish the bigger things in life. These little moments all began back in 2021, 18 months ago, when we walked through the gates at De La Salle Cronulla, eager to unlock a new chapter in our life. At this time, I was excited about the future and look towards the bigger picture without realising how important the little things are. After what was a smooth semester, COVID struck again, and while some of us enjoyed the extra free time at home, we missed the little things that make De La Salle College such a great place to be. the little smile of your teacher as you walk into class, or saying hi to your friends at recess and lunch. After countless emails, COVID tests, and Zoom lessons, we persevered and stand here today, having demonstrated resilience against the challenges of isolation and homeschooling. This experience has also prepared us for the uncertainties and challenges we will face in the real world. Whilst I have spoken about all the little things and highlights we have experienced along the way, these would not have happened without the dedicated, hardworking, and truly amazing staff at De La Salle Cronulla. Teachers, you have made the last 2 years such an amazing experience, and we would not have achieved what we have without you. We truly appreciate you, your hard work, and the time and effort spent preparing our lessons, marking, editing, and making sure each and every one of us reached our full potential. You are the role models we needed, and we want to express our gratitude for supporting and helping us to achieve our goals, as well as encouraging us to be the best person we can. I would also like to thank Mr. Marnie, our principal, Mrs. Morrison, our assistant principal, as well as our Year 11 coordinator, Mrs. Vukovic, and Mrs. Cullen and Mr. Janestra. Under your leadership, we've been inspired to work hard, respect others, and be prepared for the future. To Mrs. O'Connor, our current year advisor, you are amazing and always go above and beyond. Thank you for your patience, support, and guidance in helping us make it through Year 12 and being that special someone that we could always turn to for guidance. Finally, I would like to thank our parents and caregivers. Thank you for being our primary educators and for the love and support you have provided along the way. Knowing you believed in us made us believe in ourselves. Whilst we may not always show and appreciate how much you do for us, we are extremely grateful for your time, your encouragement, and your support and love. Our successes will forever be a testament to your hard work and persistence. To the graduating class of 2022, the little things along the way would not have been so memorable without each and every one of you. The smiles, the jokes, the tears, and the ups and downs have all been a part of achieving the bigger goal of graduating tonight, and other memories we will have forever. Thank you for making our cohort such a great group of people, and for the fun and friendships we've had along the way. As we say goodbye to this chapter of our life, remember that it is the little things in life that tend to have the ripple effect. A single drop of water can create a wave of change, and so can you. Be selfless, believe in yourself, and don't let anyone change who you really are, as we all have something unique and valuable to add to this world. Go chase your dreams, seize the opportunities, and enjoy those little things in life.
A legacy. An indelible mark left for others. The example set for those who will walk behind. Today is a culmination of the legacies we have been building for the past 13 years. Legacies that will always live on in the history of De La Salle Catholic College, Cronulla. But the legacy left here is not our legacy. Rather, the legacy of those who have afforded us this journey. To all the families gathered before us, upon reflection on these past 13 years, I am sure you can vividly remember the moment we left your arms for the very first time. Eager, innocent, and maybe even resistant kids. Just kids. Now to think we have journeyed through 13 years of schooling, and one constant throughout it all has been you, our families. You have witnessed an immense amount of growth during this period, both physically and emotionally. You watched our uniforms slowly become too tight, our school shoes rendered useless after just one semester. You watched us proudly take the stage for an award or parade our Gala Day medals upon our necks. You have watched us build lifelong friendships, connect personally with teachers, and most of all, find our place as individuals in this world. And now we have the privilege to celebrate one final milestone with you. We thank you for the role you played in guiding us towards success, in whatever way that may have been. Personally, I can confidently say that I would not be standing on this stage today if it wasn't for the values my parents instilled in me. Values of hard work, perseverance, and most importantly, kindness. To the staff. It is so rare to be surrounded by a group of individuals so dedicated to their job. Your job was not only to prepare us for the challenge that the HSC will present, but a job larger than any textbook can fulfill. Preparation for our transition into the real world. The pride I feel for this college is a testament to the environment you have and will continue to create. I will always look back on my time at DLAR with fondness because of the role you played in my journey and the journeys of each student gathered here. I would like to make special mention to the executive, Mr. Marnie, Mrs. Morrison, Mrs. Cullen, Mr. Cullerton, Mr. Robertson, Mr. Ginestra, and Mrs. O'Connor. It has been a pleasure to grow as a leader under your guidance. To our Year 11 coordinator, Mrs. Vukovic, and our current Year 12 coordinator, Mrs. O'Connor, thank you for making these past 2 years so impactful and memorable. To my peers, the graduating class of 2022. Thank you for placing your trust in our guidance and leadership. I am so honored to have had the opportunity to be your voice in one of the biggest years of our lives. I know these past few years have not been easy. Real life connections became non-existent. We were confined to within 5 kilometres of our home. And many of us lost motivation to remain committed to our study. Despite the repeated challenges thrown at us, we gather here today as a collective group, equipped to begin the rest of our lives. Take confidence in the fact that in the darkest of times, you rose to the top. And always remember that a bend in the road is not the end of the road unless you fail to make the turn. So I say to you as my last remarks, the world will always be what you make of it. Put your best foot forward. Lunge at every opportunity, take the leap of faith, and involve yourself in every aspect of life. Because life is way too short, and time travels way too fast. The shadows will lengthen, the sun will set, but the legacies will forever live in our hearts. Thank you from the bottom of mine.
You two are a very hard act to follow. We now come to the presentation of our graduation certificates for all our fabulous Year 12 students. The Year 12 homeroom teachers will in sequence read their names. Their Year 12 coordinator, Mrs. Rachel O'Connor, will present with our college principal, Mr. Marnie, their certificates. And hopefully we've organised it so that if you want to stand and take a photo with your phone, you're able to. At the end of each group, they will gather here at the altar. And again, if you can bob through Mr. Hurst taking a photo, you're welcome to do the same.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the graduands of Benilde 2022. Georgia Aegis. Christopher Andrews. Brent Annabelle. Talia Arena. Jade Bacon, Pablo Benitez Hernandez, Chrysanthi Berevescos, Jessica Bond, Eva Borg, Panos Pateras, Taj Braley, Sophie Bray, Benjamin Buchholz, Blake Butterfield, Harry Cave, Oscar Cave, Jack Cameron, Joshua Carter, Leah Cassidy, Jessica Eady, and Brendan Fairs. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the graduates of 12 Benilde 2022.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Carmody 2022. Jessica Chaloner. Logan Charlton. Victoria Chen. Maxwell Churchyard. Jack Clapham. Brody Clark, Mia Cleary, Logan Coffey, Archie Copeland, Esperance Coppelson, Natalie Cox, Patrick Crozer, Marley Cross, Isabella Demetrio, Alex DeLucio, Caitlin Donahue, Braden Downing, and Niamh Durack.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to introduce the graduates from 12 Chisholm. Alec Durante. Nick Durkin. Chloe Dodd. Grace Elliott. Noah Fennick, Charlotte Franks Pearson, Isabella Fulford, Charlotte Fullerton, Phoebe Gadulla, Zane Galea, Michaela Georgievsky, and Sarah Gleason. Ladies and gentlemen, the Year 12 graduates from Chisholm.
I'm pleased to present to you the graduates of Hours 2022. Nathan Green. Kira Greening. Henry Grounds. Chantel Harper. Keanu Hawes. Grace Heyman. Christopher Hoff. Alexander Huddleston. Jacob Inkalingo. Angelique Jinks. Anthony Joma. Anna Jordanov. Paloma Judd. And Scarlett Mandage. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of 12 hours.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of MacKillop 2022. Michaela Cadlick. Brianna Kelly. Nicholas Kalianis. Frankie Karabetsos. Giselle Kay, Lachlan Kentwell, Kennedy Knight, Peter Kostopoulos, Stephanie Kubrowska, Christian Kukiewski, Bianca Rose Kurtovich, Luke LaFan, Ben Lagalo, Brooke Lancaster, Ruby Lancaster, Brady Leckie, Lily Lennox, Riley Lester, Wilson Lynn, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of 12 MacKillop 22.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of Macaulay 2022. Harrison McDougall. Mateus Macedo. Piper Maguire. J. Felix Mandilli. Sean McQueeran. Alexander Matter. Ethan Matthews. Liam Maxwell. Jack McCreary. Kale McInerney. Rory McKell. Kira McCrae. Ashley Metters. Tyson Misser. Emma Mulder. And Benjamin Bullock. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 12 Macaulay 2022.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the graduates of McGill 2022. Adam McMahon. Jessica Munoz. Savannah Murphy. Nicholas Mirilakis. Jade Newbury, Tiana Connor, Abby O'Donnell, Dominic Offria, Sienna Oden Somerville. Aaliyah Panarello, Chloe Parnell, George Passis, John Perot, Philip Perry, Sienna Pincus, Zach Ponte, George Pooley, Ella Porter, Mia Porter, Emma Pryor, Peter Cerulis, Charlotte Rainey, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of 12 McGill.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of O'Connor 2022.
Kane Fowler.
Joseph Ramachandra. Joseph Ramirez, Sophia Randazzo, Logan Reardon, Peter Remolino, Ashley Robb, Chloe Rooney, Takara Rose, Declan Rule, Christopher Russell, Suzanne Ryan, Sam Saito, Harley Samet, Harry Samuel, and Bailey Sanderson. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduates of 12 O'Connor 2022.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honour to present to you the graduates of Paulding 2022. Jasmine Saunders. Oliver Savides. Ishan Sharma. Yuvraj Sharma. Alexandra Singleton. Dakota Sinizic. Connor Skanavis. Zachary Slater. Ty Smith. Karel Snunu. Sama Sashaki. Charlotte St. Baker. Isabella Stemboljowska. Nicholas Stone Street. Benjamin Sutton. Mackenzie Swaysland. Benjamin Sweeney. And Ray Sai. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of 12 Paulding.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the graduates of Slattery 2022. Luke Takis. James Tilevsky. Jessica Tilevsky. Christopher Tanti. Mark Tennant. Christina Theodoratis. Tara Thornley. Dylan Turner. Joshua Tildesley. Tane Vanzino. Landon Walker. Paige Walker. Zane Watson. Sarah Wellington. Lucy White. Charlie Winnie. Jack Wright. Ladies and gentlemen, lucky last, I present to you the graduates of 12 Slattery 2022.
We might just give all our Year 12 graduates one more round of applause. Good evening, everyone. My name is Mr. John Cullerton, and I'm the leader of student wellbeing. On behalf of the wellbeing team, I'd like to pass on my congratulations to all Year 12 graduates and their families. And it's my honour to announce some of our major awards for this evening. I would like to ask our curriculum coordinator, Mr. Tony Genestra, along with our principal, Mr. Stephen Marnie, to present our first group of major awards. Our first set of awards are for the achievement of academic excellence for 2022. The criteria for this award are for students who have consistently achieved a high standard in a minimum of 10 units based in the college assessment program. This year's recipients are Jade Bacon, Eva Borg, Harry Caff, Oscar Caff, Victoria Chen, Isabella Dimitriou, Jessica Eady, Charlotte Fullerton. Michaela Georgeski. Anna Jordanov. Nicholas Kalianis. Lachlan Kentwell. Wilson Lynn. Adam McMahon. Zach Ponte. Suzanne Ryan. Harley Samet. Zachary Slater. Luke Takas. Can we please congratulate all of this year's recipients? The next award is the Youth Partnership Award for Vocational Education and Training Excellence for 2022. The criteria for this award includes a student who has consistently worked at a high level in all class activities, a student who has completed all assessment tasks to an excellent standard, a student who has always displayed a positive attitude and interest in a VET subject, and a student who has completed their mandatory work placement component to a high standard, receiving positive feedback from their host employer. This year's worthy recipient is Benjamin Buchholz. Our next award is the Olympic Changemaker Award. This award is given to a student who has shown leadership and commitment throughout their time at the college in the area of sport. This year's recipient has been a valuable member of the De La Salle Opens Rugby League team. He has shown dedication and leadership skills both on and off the field and has been a great mentor for the younger players of the team, always inspiring others to achieve their best and leading by example on the field. This year's award winner is Zane Watson. The next two awards are also in the sporting arena. The Sportsman and Sportswoman Awards are presented to students who have represented the college in different levels of sport in Year 11 and Year 12. Students are awarded points throughout each year and they represent as they represent the school, region or state. The individual with the highest tally is the recipient of the award. Our sportswoman for 2022 was selected in the New South Wales Triple C Hockey Opens team and played at the All Schools level competition in Newcastle in July. The sportswoman for 2022 is Alexandra Singleton. The sportsman for 2022 represented the college across a number of sports. In triathlon, which unfortunately this year was abandoned due to the flooding. Cross country, where he placed third at conference level and third at Sydney Catholic Schools level. And also at athletics, where he placed third at the conference level for 2022. Congratulations to our sportsman of 2022, Zane Galea. Our next award is the Creative Arts Award for 2022. This award is presented to a student who has contributed to the Creative Arts program across our whole school community. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Alec Durante. The Australian Defence Force sponsors two awards for Year 12 graduates across the country. The first is the Australian Defence Force Long-Term Leadership and Teamwork Award. This award recognises the student who demonstrates leadership and teamwork within both the school and broader community, and who displays strong values such as doing one's best, respect for others, and mateship that is integral to our Australian society. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Charlotte Fullerton. The second award is the ADF Future Innovators Award. And this award recognises a student who demonstrates innovation and motivation in the learning areas of STEM, science, technology, and maths. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Adam McMahon. Congratulations to this first set of award winners. We now come to our most prestigious awards, and I would like to invite our college vice principal, Mrs. Michelle Morrison, to announce the awards, and our college principal, Mr. Marnie, and our parish priest, Father James, to present these awards.
This first award is the Salle Medal of Service, and it's awarded to recipients of our community for their service to the college, the local parish, and the wider community. This gold award is given to students who have spent in excess of 50 hours committed to our college. This year's recipients are Brendan Fares, Charlotte Fullerton, and Sean McQueerin. Our next award is the St Vincent de Paul Award for Community Service. Recipients of this award have demonstrated a very strong sense of social justice for all people. It includes commitment to both community service, to the ethos and values of St Vincent de Paul Society, setting a positive example for other students, and living out the gospel messages by serving those in need. This year, we recognise two students who have demonstrated commitment to service within our community and being wonderful role models for others while they live out those gospel values. This year's recipients are Scarlett Mandich and Charlotte Rainey. This next award was actually presented a little earlier this month, but it's a very prestigious award. It's given by the Archbishop of Sydney to one Year 12 student in every Sydney Catholic High School. I'd like to invite Adam McMahon to read the citation that was given to our very worthy recipient, Sean McQueerin.
Sean McQueerin is a dedicated and active parishioner of St Aloysius Cronulla, regularly altar serving at parish and school masses as well as events since 2012. Within the parish, Sean is an extraordinary minister of the Holy Communion and has completed his studies to become an acolyte. He promotes the mission of the Catholic faith community as a catechist at Burrany Bay Public School, teaching scripture weekly. In 2021, he assisted in training young confirmation candidates for altar serving, participated in the parish interfaith program with the Muslim community, and assisted with live streaming of weekly masses during COVID restrictions. Sean contributes to the Catholic faith life of the college as he is LaSallian youth leader, where he has promoted initiatives for Caritas and LaSallian Women of Hope. Sean has represented the college in 2020 Cancer Council Relay for Life and the 2021 Clancy Art Exhibition as a recipient of the Brother Kelvin Canavan and Brian Jordan Awards. Congratulations to Sean McQueerin.
Our next award is a Catechist Award for Outstanding Classroom Practice over 2022. The Catechist program at the college has been running for 14 years. It's a significant commitment and partnership with the parish. This year, we had over 60 catechists who were engaged in teaching students at Burrany Bay Primary School. This award recognises five particular students for their outstanding contribution to supporting the parish. Chloe Dyde, Charlotte Fullerton, Grace Heyman, Pablo Benitez Hernandez,
and Joseph Ramachandra. Congratulations to all our recipients. I would now like to ask Brother John Peel, representing the Lasallian Brothers, to join us in presenting this next award. This award is the Brother Celestine Award for service to the college community in 2022. It's awarded to a student who has been selfless in their understanding of others and their willingness to assist. They've demonstrated organisational and communication skills in motivating our students to support the variety of activities that were organised at the college this year. This year's recipient is Zach Ponte. Thanks, Brother John, and congratulations, Zach. The Lasallian Award for Contribution to the Religious Life at the College for 22 is awarded to the student who has expressed the ethos and the values of St. John Baptist de La Salle in their everyday life at the college. This year we have two recipients, Brendan Fares. And Sean McQueeran. Our final and most prestigious award is the St. John Baptist de La Salle Medal Award for 2022. This is awarded for outstanding commitment and ability across all areas of school life, which include academic work, leadership, sport participation, college spirit, and witness to the gospel values. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Charlotte Fullerton. Congratulations to all our major award winners tonight. Now, an evening like this doesn't come together easily, as I'm sure you know, so a few thank yous to people. A huge thank you to Father James for the beautiful Mass celebration that we had tonight, ably supported by Father Frank and Father Michael. They are strong supporters of our community, and we really appreciate the deep connection that we have with our parish. Thank you also to the Lasallian Brothers for their attendance tonight through the representation of Brother John. We'd also like to thank our musicians and our singers, ably led by Mrs. Leonard, who made this tonight's experience quite beautiful. Thanks, guys. Thank you also to our altar servers, our readers, all those who contributed to our Mass tonight, particularly Mrs. Hughes and Mrs. Cullen, whose organisation behind the scenes has been very busy and very full on, and we really appreciate the effort put into the significant celebration. Thank you all. Thank you to the parents and friends of our graduating class for your presence and participation on this wonderful occasion. Well done, you made it. And last, but by no means least, we thank and wish with all our heartfelt wishes our graduation class of Year 12, 2022. And for our final act this evening, can I ask Mr. Cullerton and Mrs. O'Connor to lead Year 12 out?